In engineering, we deal with various bodies, frames, machines, and other structures. Eventually, all systems transfer their loading to the ground. This is accomplished by connecting a series of elements. It's very important we understand what these connections are. These connections are typically known as supports. The supports can also be called as joints or constraints. Each of these connections is designed to support a specific type of loading condition. Since supports hold the bodies in place, they resist unwanted motion and therefore create reaction forces, which we will call as support reactions. Quite often our goal is to determine the support reactions in equilibrium problems. Let's start with cable supports. Take a look at this example where a traffic light is supported by two cables. Or another example where a weight is supported by a cable system. Cables, wires, and ropes are widely used in the industry. They can support only tensile loads. So anytime you see a cable in your system, you can replace the cable with the force along the cable in the direction that pulls the cable. When it comes to rigid bodies, they can be supported not only by cables, but by other means as well. The three common supports which join two bodies are pin support, roller support, and a fixed support. There are also other types of supports, but in this session, we will limit our discussion to cable, pin, roller, and fixed supports. Let us consider the pin support. A pin support is typically represented by the figures as shown here. A pin support is very, very popular. Take a look at this beam with holes. Here I have a Lego compatible part made of metal. It has many holes, and here I have a black pin. I can insert this pin into one of the holes of this beam, and this beam is now supported by a pin. Now, watch this. This beam can rotate about Z-axis, but it cannot move along X direction or Y direction. Let's take a look at another example of a pin support. Here I have a scissor, and it has got two parts, upper handle with a blade and a lower handle. These two parts are connected by a pin right here. This pin allows the part to rotate. Notice this. This pin does not allow the parts to move horizontally or vertically with respect to each other. It only allows rotation. So this is a pin support. In other words, pin support resists both vertical and horizontal forces, but not a moment. So, this is how we treat pin support from now onwards. Anytime you see a pin support, replace that with two forces, one horizontal and one vertical. Now let's consider the roller support. A roller support is typically represented by the figures as shown here. Roller support allows rotation and translation along the surface upon which the roller rests. This support is widely used in the industry to account for thermal expansion of structural elements such as beams. This support allows the body to rotate as well as move along the surface. Here's an example for roller support. This is a slotted beam. You can see the two slots, and it is used in many experiments. You can see there are some parts in the slot. In this case, you see a disc connected to a pin. And as you can see, these parts can rotate. You can see this pin can rotate and slide along the slot. This is a roller support. The support resists translation motion along the axis perpendicular to the surface. This means it has only one support reactions along this vertical axis. So this is how we are going to treat roller support from now onwards. Anytime you see a roller support, replace that with the force in the direction where the motion is resisted. All right? Now, let's consider fixed support. A fixed support is typically represented by the figures shown here. A fixed support is also called as built-in support or a rigid support. This support is very, very common. A beam built into a structure is a fixed support. Or you can imagine fixed support like a tree that grows from the ground. Fixed supports can resist vertical, horizontal motion, as well as the moments. So they will have three support reactions. So this is how we are going to treat fixed support from now onwards. Anytime you see a fixed support, replace that with two forces, one horizontal and one vertical, and a moment. With a good understanding of how to model support reactions, we are now ready to solve two-dimensional rigid body equilibrium problems.